Hello everyone and welcome back to another video, or welcome if you're new. I'm Cora and today we are back in CreatorSim creating a country girl, as you can read from the title, I guess. I'm very tired, so apologies if I'm all over the place or something. This work week has been a little bit crazy and I've always had something to do after work. Like yesterday I was literally baking this cake for ever. It was so much, like, it was just such a time consuming cake that I had to make for my mom's work, and well, I didn't have to, but I offered her to, so it's kind of my fault, I guess. And I hated it. It was like chocolate covered, and boy do I hate covering cakes in chocolate. It just always goes wrong and it's messy, and I don't like it, okay? But anyways, with that said, I am tired, so bear with me a little bit, please. And I can't record this voiceover any later, it's currently Wednesday, but on Friday I will have a sleepover at work, which, yay, I guess. Don't know if I will be doing much sleeping. I hope I will at least get a few hours, so cross your fingers for me on Friday, okay? Please, I need it. I need my beauty sleep. But anyways, we are creating this sim called Kendra today. And oh, she turned out so gorgeous. Like, when I was done with her, I was like, oh my god, I love her. Like, I think she's so cute. I don't know what it is. Tell me if you like her and let me know what your favorite outfit is, because whenever I create Sims and give them an outfit for each of the categories, I'm always like, I wonder what your guy's favorite outfit is. I think mine is between the everyday and the hot weather. I think I really like those two, but yeah, the cold weather, sorry. Like I said, I'm all over the place. But yeah, between the everyday and cold weather, so let me know which yours are. The CC links are all in the description. You can get them either on my Tumblr or on a Google Doc, whichever you prefer. And she's also available on the gallery under the hashtag ThisSimPanions, or my gallery ID is also ThisSimPanions, which is always linked down below in the description if you're looking for it. But anyways, let's get into her story a little bit, shall we? So I believe it all happened when I gave her this like flannel thing. It's actually a new piece by one of my favorite CC creators, Clumsy Alien, and it's so cute. And I was like, ah, oh, this kind of reminds me of someone that lives on a farm. And then I was like, oh, she could totally be a country girl, you know. So I believe she grew up in a family with 6 siblings. I believe she is the oldest of all of them. Her family owns a really big farm with loads of different animals and stuff, and I don't think they kill them, okay, because I'm a vegetarian, so that's not what they're doing. They're probably just selling animal products, you know, like eggs and milk and stuff, because we need to keep the animals alive. I love them too much to kill them, so it can't even happen in a Sims story, okay? But that's what I believe. I believe her parents are really loving, you know, they've had a lot of kids, and obviously her as the oldest, she's always kind of helped out with the kids and always been kind of the responsible one that was there for all of them when her parents were out working on the farm. And I believe she loves that life. I gave her the aspiration where she wants a big happy family, because I believe that honestly is her life goal. Like, just growing up with a big family, she's always loved having the trouble around her, and if no one's there, she just feels like it's a bit quiet and she doesn't really like that. But I feel like lately, when she became a bit older, you know, she started wondering if working on the farm is what she wants to do for the rest of her life, and like taking care of her younger siblings. Because I do believe they're all quite far apart in age. I do believe her youngest sibling was probably just born a few years ago, and she just like feels like she needs to start her own kind of thing, you know, like maybe move out, even though I think she would struggle doing that. I believe she is kind of torn between being a grown-up and moving out and like standing on her own 2 feet, but also being with her family. I believe it would be really hard for her to move out, you know, because she loves her family and she knows that they kind of need her also to help out on the farm, but she just started feeling like it's maybe not what she wants to do anymore. And as the oldest, her parents always wanted her to, you know, take over the farm and yeah, just be responsible for it when they're too old for it or when they die eventually. But she's just kind of starting to think maybe that is not what she wants to do. And I don't believe she actually has a plan on what she wants to do. I don't know if she wants to go to college or if she wants to just start a career somewhere, like, who knows, I don't. But I believe she is kind of torn between those two worlds, you know, and I believe it is hard if you have a family where you know they kind of depend on you, but you also want to start your own family and your own life, and you can't obviously always be there for everyone. And I think that's something she needs to learn, you know, to put her own needs, not first, but like a bit higher than she puts them now, because I believe her whole life, because she is the oldest one, she just kind of stepped back from her own needs and from what she wants and just did what was expected from her. And I don't believe her parents meant any harm to her. I think she was just always offering as well, you know, because that's just the person she is. I think she is a very cute person and super helpful, and she just wants to be there for her parents. And I do believe they're quite old already, because she is already a young adult, you know, but they obviously still had a child, so they can't be that old. I don't know. I haven't figured that out yet. but I kind of do hope that, you know, if you play with her, she can kind of make a living for herself, maybe find out what her passion is. I just gave her very generic traits, I'd say, like she's family oriented because obviously she grew up with a big family and she wants her to have a big family herself one day, so that was just an obvious trait for me. And then she's also cheerful and she loves the outdoors, which are like, I don't know, I think the cheerful was just the vibe I was getting from her. I don't know, I would believe she smiles a lot and stuff. And also the outfit that I gave her now, I struggled a little bit with what top I want to have with it, because I kind of wanted like a western looking blouse, but I couldn't find one that I liked. And I did love the flannel with it, but I didn't want to give her the flannel for the party wear as well, because I was like, no, you've already used it for every day, you know, you can't. I mean, I could have used it twice, or I could have used it in a different color swatch, but I don't know, I always want the outfits to be quite unique. Apart from the animal lover cast that I made a few days ago, where I actually thought, I didn't mention that in the video, I don't believe, but she was like a very minimalistic sim, and I do believe she also cares about the environment and stuff, so I gave her a few shoes and tops that she's already worn in previous outfits, because I was like, she probably doesn't have too many different clothing items, you know, she just reuses them for different outfits. So I thought that was a cute detail, but like for the party wear, I finally settled on this really cute, like, I don't know, just t-shirt thingy, and I think it's so cute, and I absolutely love the cowboy boots. It was just a given to me, you know, when I was like, ah, she's probably like a country girl, I was like, she needs some cowboy boots. And then I gave her some wellies for her cold weather outfit, and I absolutely adore the jacket that we're gonna use for the cold weather outfits. It's just so nice, I don't know, I love it. But yeah, that's pretty much it about this sim. I absolutely love her. Like, I don't know, there's just, sometimes I create sims and I instantly have like a connection to them. It's so weird, like, I don't know, but she's just so cute, and she seems like such a genuine person, you know, she's gorgeous, let's not forget about that. And I do believe she's just a good person, you know, so it makes me want to be friends with her. I want to be friends with a sim. but yeah, I'm interested, like I said in the beginning, to know what your favorite outfit is. And if you like her, I honestly do hope you do, because imagine I'm just hyping her and I'm like, she's so pretty, and everyone's just kind of like, okay, she's not my favorite. But yeah, I always want to play with, when I create sims that I really, really love, I'm like, I need to play with them. But I already have so many different households and save files and stuff, and I'm like, I can't. I kind of need to wait. But maybe if I, like, she could be a, like, potential partner for one of my sims in a Let's Play, and then I could play with her as well, so that would be fun. But anyways, with that said, I hope you did enjoy the video. And if you did, please don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already. And I will see you all next time. Bye! Searching isn't finding.
trip, I can't believe.